Hello everyone, so we're bringing K-Stick back, you know, thanks for the 10 minutes break, and I want to thank K-Stick for spending his time today to explain to us, you know, about the topic that we're trying to stage audience continuum, yeah. And I just want to appreciate everyone that has joined this platform to, you know, to listen to what K-Stick has to say. So now I'll be going live back with K-Stick. And I believe that you will enjoy this. Hello, everyone. So, like I said, you know, Music Business Intelligence is just a forum whereby we try to educate, you know, artists, music business potentials all over the globe on how they can maximize their potentials in music and reach out to the world. And thanks to Dr. Kunle Pemiloye K-Stick, popularly known as K-Stick, a veteran in the music industry, who has impacted, you know, the industry so much. You know, for like a decade now, K-Stick has been relevant in the music industry in Nigeria. Recently, he relocated to the US of A in California and doing very well too. And so we just want to learn from his wealth of experience and see how we can apply it into our personal lives. You know, we've learned so much from him today, and we hope to, you know, to learn more. We hope to learn more. Let me celebrate K-Stick again. Just give high five. If you are there, just give high five. Thank you so much for joining. And I want us to dwell on that second to last question because, you know, I cut you short because the time is almost running to an end. And so I want you to please dwell on that again, that question. And then let's you know, continue with that. Yeah.
Okay. So the question was the element of street performance, right?
Yes.
So I talk about confidence. Confidence is very crucial for you to maximize your stage. Your level of confidence is very crucial. And I talk about how you use the stage, you know, your posture on stage, your composition on stage affects your confidence. Then stage fright also was discussed. Third one was arousing emotional interest in the audience. You know, it's very crucial for you to get a good performance. So I stopped at mistake, right? Climax. Do your best to build climax in your song. And the anti-climax has to do with, if you're not careful, if your song choice are not well arranged, find out you get to climax. If you're not careful now, you experience what they call anti-climax also, which is not the best. Always arrange your song to build climax. So I stop at mistake. Mistake is a major one because most people don't plan. People don't plan to fail, but in a way, find out each time they climb my mount stage. One thing that militates against the building climax or getting that result faster from the audience is mistakes. Mistakes even affect your self-confidence. The more mistakes happen, the more, you know, you withdraw. And I was saying that if you notice a mistake, don't stop, you know. Don't let it show on your face, you know. If possible, that's when you should even put on smiling face, you know, and go on. Now, avoiding mistakes, there's some things we need to do, you know. We've seen several artists, top elite artists, using stage and probably they're not sure, they stumble and they fall. See, great artists, they probably express that on several occasions, you know. Maybe they stumble on something on stage. E.g. now, it's not advisable to wear new shoe to perform. A brand new shoe from experience. Some true research has shown that brand new shoe that you're not comfortable with, you're not sure of with, on the stage, brand new shoe on the stage you're not used to, it's always, sometimes always leads to mistakes of, you know, stumble. So I think that, you know, it's good that, you know, once you take note of that, you know, if you must wear brand new shoe, make sure you wear that shoe for dress rehearsal, so, you know. Come on, say with the shoe, so that you can be sure of how much the shoe can grip the floor very well. Or else it affects your confidence. So that may even lead to mistake. So very crucial. And then also aside from not good to, not, that the fact that it's not good to that you wear brand new shoe to, on a new all that you're not used to. Let me also go into the aspect of that what makes people what are the technical challenges now why people make mistakes. I mean on technical level now. Preparation. When you're not well prepared, you know, you find out that you're not approved on stage. So I think that there's some element I want to list here about that gives confidence that helps you prepare well for concert so that you can avoid mistakes on stage. Learning music line by line is very crucial. People rehearse wrongly. They rehearse in the wrong way. In fact, most people practice when they should be rehearsing. There are times you should stop practice, convert your practice to rehearsal. There are times you should not be rehearsing, you should be practicing. Let me dwell on
sorry,
that.
Can I come in? What's the difference between practicing and rehearsing?
Exactly.
Because
exactly.
I thought if you are practicing, you are rehearsing too.
No. They're not the same thing. Not the same thing. You know. So, but of course, they're very close. They're interwoven. No.
Okay.
Practice is more of like a musical exercise that you go through to sharpen a particular skill. Like now, I want to practice how to sing octave without breaking my voice. I want to develop maybe how to ad-lib or how to play a particular riff or particular movement. For me to perfect that act, I need to practice it very well. Practice. So now I'm not having any event at hand. I'm not focused on any concert. I just want to sharpen that aspect. So that then we use word practice. The word rehearsal has to do with event. You rehearse for an event. Now you when you are preparing for a concert, you have a word like our last rehearsal.
Okay.
Our last rehearsal for social concert. Dress rehearsal. You don't say dress practice. It's okay. Dress rehearsal. So rehearsal is synonymous with a particular event you're preparing for. In fact, your best word for rehearsal is igbaradi. That means you're preparing for something. But but practice is a continuous musical exercise. After the particular event, you stop rehearsal for that event. Now we say we are rehearsing for maybe opening for inaugural whatever. We are rehearsing for New Year. Can you come? We are rehearsing for Carol concert. Okay. We are rehearsing for Easter Sunday. So now we can now bring out the aspect of practice now. Of practice is one of the subset of rehearsal. So in that rehearsal, you can have your choir going to different section. Yeah, go and practice that part. Come on, go practice that part. Go and practice your part very, very well. So some people use that word interchangeably. Rehearse that part well, but in that context, it's practice more. Practice to perfect that part. When you're all done practicing that part, you not come together to rehearse. So we rehearse for an event, and we practice over and over. So after the event, that aspect that thing you're still trying to learn, you just have to keep practicing that part. Keep practicing. So when a good musician should not stop practice. If you have a routine time, you set a goal, short term goal, long term goal. I want to learn. I want to practice. I want to perfect this particular musical art. So set the goal. How to practice them. But now, and after the concert, you stop. You may discontinue the rehearsal for that anyway. After the event anyway. You stop the other anyway after the event, but the practice should be a continuous musical exercise. If you know how to structure our rehearsal, our practice, it really encourage, it really help us in building confidence on stage. Now, I was talking about method of learning. People learn in the wrong way. Now, on the area of practice, now, Brian Tracy said, anything worth doing well. It's worth doing poorly at first. Poorly. Let me repeat. Anything worth doing well.
Okay.
Worth doing poorly. Worth doing poorly at first. Let me repeat again.
Okay.
Brian Tracy, I quote, anything worth doing well, not doing at all. What doing well is what doing poorly at first.
Yes. Okay.
So, yes, there's nothing wrong in getting it wrong at first. Most people are always afraid to get it wrong. And that's a big challenge here now. Want to appear like as Beyonce at first. Want to appear like Sinatra at first. No, there's always the beginning stage. There's nothing wrong when you make mistakes. But mistakes are part of performance. And just like your audience may not even notice the mistakes. So it's part. But they were not there with you when you were rehearsing. They didn't know your argument. So sometimes, so who says they know they notice the mistakes? So sometimes, when you experience that challenge in your performance, don't put it on your face. So learn to how to manage mistakes when they happen on stage. So and to avoid mistakes, I was saying that preparation is the key. So how did you rehearse? How did you learn that part? It's very crucial. So learning music line by line has been proven to be one of the best way to show yourself approved. Now, what do I mean by line by line? I want to learn a particular verse. You know, you don't rush to go through all the four lines at the same time. Learn first line first very well. Perfect first line very well. Second line very well. Third line, fourth line, and they will not combine. All and combine all, then bring the tempo down as low as possible. Slow the tempo down. So learn that particular act on the slow tempo very, very well, very well. And so as time goes on, now it's increase the tempo, the speed gradually to a very fast tempo. Then can you switch from fast tempo to slow tempo non-stop? Then if you can achieve that, it will be difficult for you to climb stage to make a mistake or to mount stage and make a mistake. So most people get it wrong on the level of rehearsal. Rehearse slowly and at the point, then build up. I think it's a key to mastering stage artistry. Then also developing muscle memory. Muscle memory. What do I mean by muscle memory? Now, you know, an average guy go to gym or go to workout because they want to build muscle, right? That's a goal, to build muscle. And we all want to build muscle and remove fat, right? I mean, there's a procedure doing that. Now, when you rehearse for the purpose of building muscle memory. By doing that, it will help you in building endurance on stage. That means if you're on stage, now, imagine you're on stage, you rehearse a song on a particular tempo. And maybe on the spot, the moment something happened on the stage, the drummer suddenly start playing fast, and you have to learn that, you have to sing a rush part, a fast part. The drummer probably increase the tempo beyond what you rehearse on stage. How can you go to the pace of that tempo? If you have built a muscle memory, that means you can build on you have built musical endurance. Endurance, ability to go do the same performance, the same music at different tempo, even though the tempo has shifted now. The music is faster now. Can you still go up? That's building muscle memory. At that level now, you've trained your memory to be able to go to adjust beyond the normal standard of speed or key or tone. You can do it. You can cope with it. E.g. now, you have rehearsed a song in a particular key, and somehow on stage, maybe keyboardist mistakenly play wrong key for the song as a singer, wrong key. Yeah. Or the backup singers probably sharpened the key. They went off by semitone. Because you have built endurance through muscle memory, you're able to sing that same song fluently on the new key without you getting So beat tempo, you can even make your word, your speech, your lyrics clearer because you have rehearsed the same song on a very fast tempo and a very slow tempo. So no matter what happened on the stage, you build your built on your muscle memory. You can adjust yourself to any speed. You find yourself on the stage, or a sudden change of key on the stage. You can adjust yourself to sing on that higher key. Some singers they don't really train themselves to adjust to singing the same song in a bit higher key or lower key. When that happens, say, what do you do? So for you not to get caught unaware, it's better we rehearse beyond our limit. Don't just react. Mm-hmm. I'm doing this. No, rehearse beyond the normal tempo. Do it fast. Do it slow. So in case of anything happen on stage, I think that will help you to avoid mistakes. It's a strong one to avoiding mistakes on stage. Also, learning according to the movement of the song. How do I mean? Don't just learn all the song at once. Focus on the prelude first. If I say song movement, it means the form, the song structure. Focus on the intro first. The intro, learn the intro very well before joining, connecting that with the verse. If you must sing the intro anyway, do the intro alone separately. Learn the intro also very well before you go to verse. Learn the verse very well. Learn the bridge very well. Learn the vamp very well. Learn the reprise. Of course, you do the reprise after the performance. Learn the coda very well. So when you learn every beat, every part of the song very well, then join everything together now. That you can now, you know, can now start from the beginning to the end. Still do it slow, do it fast. That will also help you to build muscle memory, and you'll be strong on stage with that. And finally, on this, try to build create what you call anchor. Make sure you build on performing to the point that people will ask. Anchor. Anchor means more.
Yeah.
Is audience always wishing you to stay on time, or they want to have you more? That I'm challenging you with that as an artist. If you're on stage, you're doing a song, and people are bored. They imagine, can you just leave on time, or probably they bring down their phone chatting at that moment. Something's wrong with the performance. So that's a strong element, and you should always make sure that your artist should want to make people to your performance should want to make people to ask for more. That should be your goal. They want to ask you more. Can we have more? Wow, more at that level. Then you know you're there. But when reverse is the case that they wish you think on time, I think it's not the best. So I think that it's very good that we put on all these elements in mind. It really helps us confidence. Take flight, you know, arousing emotional interest in the audience, building climax, avoiding anticlimax, avoid mistakes, and I dwell more on that. Mistakes is one major challenge. Why you disconnect with your audience? And finally, yeah. I talk about make sure your music is tailored towards people asking for encore, asking for more, and at that level, they will always want to have you back on stage.
Okay. Thank you very much. Yes. Before I go to the last question,
yes.
I want to do a quick recap.
Okay.
You understand?
Okay.
Of what we have talked about so far.
Yes.
For
yes.
Those, especially for the purpose of those that are just joining us. This is Kistik. It's a PhD holder in music. You understand? He has been in this business for over 3 decades. And you can imagine with his wealth of experience, he has actually made an indelible impact in the music industry in Nigeria. Now he resides in the US of A. You know, earlier on, we asked him about what inspired him to, you know, go into music. Please correct me when I'm wrong, if I'm wrong. We said he has started this at a very tender age. Even at the age of 15, he has started, you know, being a band leader. And yeah, and he's been doing this, and he studied music to the level of PhD. He has lectured in Obafemi Awolowo University for 9 years. He did some courses also, you know, outside the country. Please remind me, you know, on audio engineering.
Hollywood.
So, so you know, you can see, you know, building up these skills and everything. So, and I wonder, thanks, you are a musician, you are an artist, we have talent. He has told us that talent is not enough. That's one of the things I've gained there. You understand? The fact that you have talent does not mean that you should not work on your skills to ensure that you enhance your skills. So talent is not enough. If you are depending on your talent alone, you know, talent might fail you. Talent is just the beginning. It shows that you have the raw material, right? And then later you want to build up by studying more. The Bible even says we should study to make ourselves approved, right? So that's the point. So we need to study more. And then we asked him question about the fact on how the performances in Nigeria is and the US of it. One of the things he mentioned is issue of timing, that people, you know, work with time in the US. Very, you understand? Sure. And also, they also understand music, you understand? In the sense that they saturate. Yeah, we have an advantage in the sense that we can play on the spot, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Play by ear. But it's not enough. That is one of our strong cultural heritage.
Okay.
We learn by hearing, you know, by rote. But it's not enough. So sometimes we need to just document what we have, or to be able to read from the score.
Yeah.
To be an edge.
Okay. So thank you. So I think I get almost everything. And then we asked so many questions. He talked about the meaning of the concept of stage audience continuum. Yeah. I'm trying to look at the definition now. You know, stage audience continuum. You know, how to connect.
Connectivity between artist and artist stage.
And the stage.
Connect what, you know, not remove the barrier, remove the wall between you and the audience.
Audience, yeah. Thank you. And then the second question we asked him in that aspect, especially in relation to today's topic, is like you said, you should simplify it. So we asked for the meaning of stage and the meaning of audience. He gave us like three types of stage. We talk about backstage, talk about center stage.
No, part of stage.
Okay, part of stage. Okay.
Yes.
So we have backstage.
And green room.
Green room, yes.
Green, as in
green. Sorry, okay.
Color green. Green room, where the artist prepare, relax before going on stage. That's green room.
Okay.
Then backstage is where you are, where you stay before the artist until the compere invites you on stage.
Yeah.
So both green room and backstage, they are behind the stage.
Yeah. Then the third one is
center stage.
Okay.
No, so you should know when to use center stage.
Yeah.
Center left, you know.
Yeah.
You know, stage left, you know, left stage, front right. All this position, they are very crucial. If you have a good director, he will tell you backstage, front stage, center left. So you know when to stay particular time for follow spot to get you for easy visibility. So it's good to know all this background, to know about stage. But it's good to always stay at the center stage.
Center stage, yeah. I remember while I was discussing with you, you talked about spotlight too.
Yeah, exactly.
You didn't mention it today.
Yes, spotlight. One of the most important lights on the concert hall is spotlight or follow spot. They are designed to search out, to identify, or to single out the artist among the crowd on the stage. They are designed to move to go about with the singer. I mean, to move through the singer's direction or artist's direction. That's what they call it follow spot on the stage. So some of the lights, you know. Some people use moving heads also as follow spot, but there are some basic follow spot that they are designed to do that. They throw long distance from the back of the auditorium to highlight the singer. That's why people use this word in day-to-day English. Don't put me on the spot. That is a borrowed word from what follow spot. People don't want like to be put on the spot because it's a borrowed word from the theater setting that follow spotlight. I think that, you know, when you know your position on stage, when you should know when to be on the front stage, backstage, center stage, so that the director can actually move the follow spot to get you effectively. So using the stage is very crucial. I mean, maximizing the use of the stage is very crucial. When you know the stage, you get the best of the stage.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Someone quickly type it before I move on to doing the recapping. It was asking that how can they get your book. I know it's on Amazon. Is there any other way for the music distribution? Because
I've read
that book. Very, very. It's something that must be in the hand of every choir, every artist, anybody that is involved, you know, because, you know, it talks more about this, the topic that he's even talking about today, and it's more elaborate. So If you have not got that book, make sure you get it. I know it's on Amazon. Can you throw more light on where they can get it?
Quora Music. Quora Music is an outfit that you know that focus on you know the aspect of music education. You know, and one of the things that they do also that they have this book to them, so you can get the book from Quora Music. I will. But when we're done, I will get send the number so that you can on the screen.
Okay.
Quora Music also need. Two people can help out in getting the book across to us. So when we're done, I will send out the number of those two guys in charge of the book.
That's good. That's interesting. So another question that we've asked K-Stick, especially for the benefit of those that are just joining, is that we told him to explain the concept of good performance and when do we say a performance is good. And that was equally explained. We asked about the basic element of state performance, which he has just finished explaining. So the last question that we're going to ask for today is, how best can we connect with the audience? What are those challenges militating against us connecting with the audience? Can you just throw more light on?
Yeah, this is very crucial. Now, most people, with all the preparation, all the talent, all the rehearsal, all the spending, everything, they still mount the stage and they still don't connect with audience. With all you have done, you still don't connect. And this is very crucial for you. Now, the first thing to do is that knowing yourself, who are you? Knowing your area of strength. What style do I sing? What are my area of strength in moving audience, you know? Is the kind of song I'm performing? What is the relevant of my song or the value of my song to that event? When you know yourself, that you know what you are, you know, you are the area of your area of gifting, so that you know how to position yourself for that event. So first, know yourself. Or else you keep on being a photocopy, and if you're not sure yourself, you keep on copying someone. It will be bad that the same day the artist that you're copying will be invited on the same day to perform with you. So if you're not sure of yourself, that means you won't be approved on that day. You know, so I think it's good that you know yourself, know your area of strength, know your style, know what you can do well. You know, that will help you. That's one. Secondly, it's good that if having known yourself, make sure, if possible, ask the MC or the company to ask them to know what time of the day of the event are they bringing up on stage, when in the event. Now, if you know that you're an upcoming artist, and that same concert we're having A-list artists, you know, big artists there, I said big or A-list artists, I think it's good that you avoid coming after A-list artists. Imagine that you're an upcoming artist and the MC now fix you immediately after one major artist. At that level, it's dangerous. But what the A-list artist will have taken the audience to a very great climax. For you to take the artist up from there, the audience up from there, you need miracle. You need to do beyond, I've faced that challenge for years, you know. No, years back, I can remember one, there was a day we had an event, I was one artist then, 1991 or so, that was to perform after Kisonade, one major event, Kisonade. So, the band leader should have probably discussed with the MC or organizer to bring us before Kisonade. Yeah. But I think the guy didn't get his scope. So they brought us after Kisonade.
Okay.
Remember, before climbing stage, we're already afraid. Tension was already setting because at that level, the height was so tense that the band leader could not even, get his feet on the song. So by the time we got to the first verse of the song, I mean the intro, first verse, people started going home. People started leaving. And the more people start living on you, that alone kills morale. So if you're an upcoming artist and the MC happened to fix you after A-list artist, that could be a major challenge in you connecting with the audience. But the audience, by that time, would have had their full. And at that level, for you to take them to next level, that means you have one unique style. You have one unique style that people are looking out for. Or maybe your brand, you already built a brand. But if you're an upcoming artist, they've not known you with a brand, they've not known you with a song, with a style, then I think it's good that you start before, let me bring you up before A-list artists. Because at that level, audience are still much more receptive. They want to listen to you.
Yeah.
But even though the MC is trying to pin them down with those A-list artists, then you can have your way. Have your way in court at that level. You know, have your feel then before, you know. And the more you do the performance, the more you build yourself, the more you work on your brand, you also try to build up yourself to become get to the level of A-list artist. But if you are an upcoming artist, avoid coming up after A-list artist. It may affect you connecting with the
audience.
Also, your song choice is very crucial. Your song choice. Even though you love all the songs in your album, and you, it may be that in that event, you may not start with your own song in your album, but you're not known. The artist, you're not known. Not to talk of your song being known. So, because you're not known, it's good that you start with. From general to specific. From general, I mean that start with known song. At that level, you can sing known copyright song, song that people are used to.
Yeah.
You can use that to build yourself to get acceptance. You know, sing known song and start from general. Then you have a end result. I mean, you have a goal. Your goal is to sing your song, right? Your track, your title track or whatever. You want to launch out your song. Start with known song, if possible. There's nothing wrong in singing song of mega artists like Sinatra, you know, Waymaker. It's very rare for you to raise a song like I Know Where I Am, Waymaker, or Mac Abdul's song, Tim Duffy's song. These are known song to get the audience acceptability. When you sing those songs, you get everybody sing along with you. That will calm the tension, you know, and that will get them across to you easily. You get your balance there. So start from the general. General means singing known song. Let everybody join you. No, then the more you get that, you know, start moving down now to your specific, to your own song. So, but if that is the case, an experienced artist always start with specific, you know. And if you start, you're not known, your song is not known. At that level, how can you get audience alongside with you? So the more you get the attention first with a known song, then go into your own song. At that level, they are much more, calm, you know, more attentive, attentive to receptive to your song. So I think it's a crucial one, you getting audience attention. Start from general to specific. But you know what? The reverse is the case. A major artist now, any artist can start from specific straight. Imagine a Snag on stage. Snag can just go straight to one newly composed song. You know, imagine Beyonce or Marvin Sapp, mount stage. And all the, for the first 3 minutes, all they are singing just ha, 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 ha. Just this is ha alone. People would see it as style, and they would join. But you imagine you upcoming artist singing So it's good that when you're not known, you're moving up to that level of stardom. I think that it's good that you learn to take things from the general, you know, be careful, not don't just go, you know, that direction. I think that's very crucial. So knowing your song, the choice of song, you know, you may even prepare some song before performance. Mere getting to the hall, auditorium, or backstage, you may have to change the song. You may call your band. You know what? Let's start with the total song. Let's rearrange. You're talking about you, moving around the song. You know, you have to go beyond or go off your rehearsal sometimes. And don't forget that I talk about muscle memory. If you react very well, like you know, you react beyond normal, beyond your normal confined territory. When you get to the stage and you have to adjust on the spot moment, you can adjust easily. So let the audience sometimes determine what you sing. Sometimes you have seen them, except if it's the classical music when you're singing everything's on rote, everything written down. You're playing for note for note, hard. But if it's a popular music and more dance music, then you're free to sometimes adjust. So know when to change, to adjust your choice of song. It really helps you to get audience attention easily. And then also, it's very crucial that you dwell more on repetition rather than contrast. How do I mean? Even though I know that repetition leads to boredom, we know. But sometimes it's good to make sure your song is settled on people's mind. Even though you have rehearsed very well, rehearsed in mind with the mind of having live performance and having live audience. So have them in mind, you know, even though you rehearse, make sure that with your rehearsal, make sure a part of your song is settled to be repeated over and over so that you can get your audience at attention to that song. Don't quickly, don't be quick to move to contrast, new path. Now, so I always advise that it's good that that you build on from repetition, move to variation before contrast. That means doing the same song over and over, the same part over and over. At a point, you can vary it, bring in some additions, you know, to vary the path. At that level, you're still connecting your audience. Then you can now move to contrast in the long run. So repetition, variation, and contrast is very crucial. Then finally, keep your style. Let them know. Don't forget that we talk about starting from general, to specific. But then you get the acceptance. Then keep that style. You have to sing the same song for months. Let them know you with a song for years, so that when they know you with a style for in the long run, they will accept you. They will know you as the authority in that field. One thing that has helped me is that for a long time, I've always kept a style. I've been keeping my style for years, my style of drumming. That's why each time I find myself in a mix of authority, great drummers, you know, I still play my style. And at that level, I'm still relevant. Even in conducting, I have my style. Keep your style. Always have your style. It's very crucial. Have your style. It's very, very important. I think that will help you to, you know, get your audience, you know, keep your style. Be yourself. Be original. Very important, you know. So I think, you know, so it's very important, you know, you know.
Thank you very much, man. Guys, what you are getting there, you know, is what you need to, is something that you need to pay for. This is what he has gotten over 30 years, and we are getting it free of charge. And you know, so we need to appreciate Kestik. This is wow. This is wow. Even for me, I've learned a lot. I've learned a lot from what you have said today. I really appreciate you. So I'm going to really talk about what we are doing here, what Music Business Intelligence is, what Woodcliff is. But in the process, while I'm doing that, if you have any question, please type it here. We are going to ask Kestik, and Kestik will answer those questions. If you have any questions, please type them in and let's ask Kestik. This is an opportunity for you because, you know, you need to understand how this thing has been done, you understand? So that we can perform and minister cross-culturally, globally, taking your music from the local level to global level, you understand? Because it's very, very important if you really want to move ahead in the music industry. Yes. as Christians. Most of the time, you know, we just, you know, pipe low and not sharpening our skills, understanding the business of music. And that's the essence of establishing this platform, to bring veterans, those who are doing well in the music industry, to come and share their wealth of experience with us. We can gain from there, and every one of us can grow and become, you know, like those who are trying to, you know, those who are trying to become like Kasich. You want to know what it takes for him to be what he is today. So it's a good thing, and we thank you for coming today. We thank you for sharing your wealth of experience. So I just want to tell you what Music Business Intelligence is all about. It's powered by Woodcliff, you understand? And Business Intelligence is a forum whereby, you know, you get educated, you understand, how to maximize your potentials in music business in a godly and in a professional manner. And, you know, and I'm also happy to be your host. My name is Kayode Olusoje. I'm a gospel artist myself. I'm a business consultant. And I'm also a digital marketing strategist. So, and that's what I do. And I bring great people that we can all learn from, you know, on this platform. Our first edition, we brought Edward Sunday. He is a renowned sound engineer. We brought Wole Oni. You all know him, a music producer who has done well also for not only Nigeria, but for Africa. You know, he did a lot of job in putting some music like Yaelu on Yamaha keyboard, you understand? So we are becoming global figures. And thank God for people like Dr. Kunle Ipimoloyi. By the time I was reading his profile, I said, you know, I just want to be like John the Baptist. You know, when he wanted to baptize Jesus, he said, he cannot stoop down to unloose the latchet of his shoes. So I don't know how to even read the profile. The man is doing very well in the industry. And we just thank God for people like this, who are impacting lives and impacting, you know, the music industry in general. So our vision, our Woodcliff is a kingdom-based musical outfit, you know, positioned to expand the frontiers of gospel music by creating multiple platforms, you understand, through which gospel artists can reach the church and the world with the word of God in unique styles. So we engage a collection of original contemporary ideas to build gospel artists and other music business professionals into international brands, you understand, so that they can minister cross-culturally and build lasting connections that we prepare their brands. So we want to see even people like Kasich, people like other, and every one of you listen to do more. See, you know, I was so happy of recent when I was listening to looking at this global pandemic period, Yari Waymaker everywhere. You know, that's the kind of thing we are talking about. You understand? So we have the potential, we have everything that it takes in Nigeria. But the point is that we don't have the right knowledge, you understand, on how to get there. And that's the essence of bringing this kind of platform, you understand, to you. So we want to celebrate Kasich today. And, you know, we've learned so much from him. If you have not got his book, please get it. And if you want to patronize him, there are a lot of things, you understand, that I can do. He's into music consultancy. Please feel free to do so. And I can bet you on this Woodcliff platform, we are planning something great that will bring these veterans, you know, to come and educate us more, you understand, and we'll be able to gain more knowledge, you know. It will be on a platform, not just on this platform, but on a platform whereby we can see ourselves face to face, you understand, and then talk more, and people share their wealth of experience, and then, you know, we'll be able to connect more, get the materials, and you'll be able to get mentoring too, and some other things. So there are some things that we're working on, and I believe that by God's grace, you'll be able to achieve this. And at the end of the day, everybody will grow. We grow together. It becomes strong together. It's just like they normally say in an adage in Yoruba that Olowo kan laarin otoshi, that is, we have a rich man among poor people. Everybody is poor. You understand? So, well, the point is that we can lift everybody up. You understand? We can lift ourselves up. We can sharpen one another. We can gain, you understand, from the wealth of experience of those who are doing well in the industry, so that everybody can grow together. You know, it's in those days I say, oh God, you know, like the way you can do it, with this global platform, you can bring a lot of people in on this online platform to do a lot. You understand? That adage is not functional again with the advent of WhatsApp, with the advent of Facebook, and some other platforms like this. So thank you, sir. Thank you very much for coming. Do you want to do again of the count? I've not seen anybody asking any questions. I hope everything is clear. You want to do a kind of recap on what we have done today, and then we just say goodbye.
Yes. So I want to encourage us to, of course, primarily know yourself, know who you are, know your style, that will help you to not to beat or stumble on stage, or when you call on stage to perform, trying to, when you see other artists around you, your confidence may, morale may drop. I think that when you know yourself, know your style, know what to prepare for, it's very crucial. They also understand the stage, understand the fact that we are on that stage because they've come to enjoy, to be blessed by your artistry. So always see audience as your friend. Don't see us audience as critic. See them as, oh, they've come to celebrate you. And that will help you to calm nerve, to calm tension. Then also, it's good that you avoid things that will easily lead to mistakes. Mistakes must happen on stage. There's no perfect performance. There's no anywhere someone perform and say that it's perfect. No, there'll be some mistakes, but it can be reduced to bare minimum. So I will discuss some elements and things that you should do that will help you to reduce or manage mistakes on stage. Also, we'll talk about the aspects of confidence, things that affect your confidence, it may also bring you down. And above all, it's always crucial that you hold on to preparation. The more you prepare, the more you master your heart. The more you prepare, the more you dazzle your audience. It's very, very crucial. Everything is all about preparation. Preparation, knowing yourself, part of the preparation. Rehearsing, it's all about preparation. To prepare for every event accordingly. Every event accordingly is very crucial. Preparation will help you to go to any height in performance. Very crucial.
Thank you
But
very much.
yeah.
It's like
So
someone has a question here, which I just want to look at. It says, it has been observed that choir management in Orthodox churches totally differs from Pentecostal. So what makes is cause for, okay, I think he's trying to say what's the cause for this dichotomy and what can be done to effect the changes.
yeah, it can't affect the change because there's something we call order of service. Orthodox Church, they have the order of service. And if that's the case for Pentecostal. No, not if that's the case. Likewise, they also have the order of service. So for the you have to know first, know your church first, know the denomination, know the order of service. I think you tailor the music to the need of the each church. You can't. It's not. It's difficult for you to compare the same musical style in the Orthodox Church, the contemporary church. I think it's not the best. You try know your church, know the pastor, know the order of service, know what they need, and it's your duty to give as a music director, give the church or the music pastor what they need that will inspire the pastor, that will inspire the members to get blessed. Not because you can't go the same way the Pentecostal and Orthodox Church. They have different background.
Yeah. I hope that question has been answered, Lord Babajide. Yeah, I hope you are satisfied with the answer. Yeah, anyway, thank you everybody for joining this platform today. You can follow K-Stick on at K-Stick Global, Global 2, at K-Stick Global 2, yeah, on Instagram. If you have more questions, feel free, talk to him. You can follow Woodcliff too on at Woodcliff. We'll be bringing a lot of veterans. I bet you we still bring K-Stick back one of these days. We'll be bringing a lot of veterans in the industry on different aspects of music, you understand, and how it can help us with our music businesses. It's not peculiar to only artists, it's also for music professionals, you understand, different music professionals, including entertainment lawyer, a lot of things that we're going to learn on this platform. So we'll be bringing a lot of people that are doing well so that we can understand a lot of aspect of music producers, video directors, we bring a lot of new photography, you understand? So tour managers, you understand, concert promoters, we bring a lot here to educate us on a lot of things so that we can understand how to go about this music business. Because I realized that even in the past, a lot of people are doing this and they are getting frustrated just because they understand the talent aspect, but not the business aspect. So we need to understand what it means to combine both the talent and the business of music together for you to excel,
yeah.
because for you to excel and to want to be encouraged to do more, you understand, you need to be profitable. Even God wants us to make profit. You know, he gave that guy 5 talents, another 2 talents, another 1 talent. The other one that buried his talent that he didn't make profit, you know, was thrown in the lake of fire. So God is not, you know, God is after us making profit, you understand, with whatever he has deposited in it. So we need to see how we want to expand our scope, you know, in the gospel music industry and the music business, to understand the way to do it better. We should be wiser than the people of the world, you understand, and do it better than them. And I believe that we'll be able to do that in Woodleaf. You know, my name is Kayode Olusoji. I'm your host today on Woodleaf platform. I'm also a gospel artist, digital marketing strategist, and a music business consultant. And I'm happy to have Dr. Kestik Pinloye today. So this book, make sure you get it. Yeah, okay.
The contact, contact Ayo, Kora Music, Aoni Jedidaya on 0803-216-1770. 0803-216-1770. Or send me mail. Of course, or Amazon. Just type Kestik or the title of the book, you know, Dynamics of Digital Performance. You have it on Amazon. And also send me a mail by KestikGlobal@gmail.com. Then we can, you know, get across to you.
Yeah.
So I think Kora Music.
Thank you very much, Kestik, for coming. Really appreciate you today. We appreciate your time. We appreciate your wealth of experience. We have learned so much from you. And I can bet you we are bringing you back again, you know, for greater stuff to do.
Thank you, everyone.
Have a lot to do. Thank you, everyone, for joining. You know, share this message to as many as possible. Let them join this platform. We'll be bringing more veterans to you. Thank you. Follow at Woodleaf and see you next time. Bye.
Thank you.
Yeah.